morning. It's a great day to be in the house of the Lord today. So glad to be back with you guys today as we take part in the Lord's Supper. It's a great day to reflect and remember on all that God has done for us. So let's stand together and sing "This Is Amazing Grace." Start with "Who Breaks the Power?"
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder?
I'm telling you what, this is going to be the best year all of us have ever had and the best year our church has ever had. Why? Because of the amazing grace of the one we serve. He gives us hope when there is no hope. He gives us a new chance this year, brothers and sisters, to serve him like never before. Hey, we're going to fellowship in just a moment. I've seen a number of guests in our room here this morning. Please welcome them, hug on them. We're thrilled to have you guests. Of course, home folks, it's always great to see you too. And thank God, by the way, this morning, that for central heating, huh? Amen. First thing I did when I got here to church this morning, I went find the thermostats. Okay, get them set. So we'll all be warm. We have so much to be thankful for. Let's pray, and then we're going to fellowship together. Father, we love you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your amazing grace. Father, we cannot say how grateful we are for the Lord Jesus Christ. You have done something that no one else could ever do. You sent him, your only begotten son, put him on that cross of Calvary. Father, he died for our sins. He rose from the dead. Because of him, we can be excited about the future. We can be excited. We can have hope that this year is going to be a fantastic year, not only in each of our lives, but in our community. Father, this morning, as we worship you, as we're gathered together as Christian brothers and sisters, Father, let us put all of our problems aside. Let us put all of our burdens aside. Let us put all the worries, the cares that we have, and just let go and worship you with everything we have. Father, let us also love each other with everything we have. Father, let us treat each other like we would like to be treated. That's the way you say to show your amazing grace, is to show it. You show us your grace, and then we show others that same grace. Father, thank you this morning. We pray as we fellowship that we will hug each other like we've never hugged each other before. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's fellowship.
As we make our way back to our seats, let's stand together and join in singing Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine.
Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. Oh, what
Amen. You can have a seat.
Aha, your day is coming, Wyatt. Good morning. It's so easy for all of us to look around and ask at the beginning of a new year, what is it we are looking for, isn't it? But what if in 2018 we didn't concentrate so much on what we're looking for, but where we are looking? We see, in order to receive our daily dose of manna, it's been promised to us in the words of John 6, 29 through 33. Jesus answered and said unto them, "This is the work of God, that you would believe on him who hath sent." They said, therefore, unto him, "What sign showest then thou that we may see and believe thee? What dost thou work?" "Our fathers did eat manna in the desert, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat." Then Jesus said unto them, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, Moses gave you not the bread from heaven, but my Father giveth you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which cometh down from heaven and giveth life unto the world." We also need to look around, don't we? So we can share the compassion of Jesus with others, as Peter wrote about in 1 Peter 3, 8 and 9. "Finally, be ye all of one mind, having compassion one of another, love as brethren. Pitiful, but be courteous. Not rendering evil for evil or railing for railing, but contrariwise blessing, knowing that ye are thereunto called, and that ye should inherit a blessing. I'd like to share with you today this little excerpt from Sue Monk Kidd's book, When the Heart Waits, which shows the very great importance of our look. In his book, Night, by German Elie Wiesel, wrote about his horrifying childhood experiences in a Nazi concentration camp. Having gone without food or drink for 3 days, thousands of Jews were driven out of their barracks at dawn into a thickly falling snow and then herded into a field, forbidden to sit or even move much. They stood in line until evening, waiting for a train that would take them even deeper into Germany. The snow drifted in a layer on their shoulders. Looking up, seeing the snow coming down, remember, snow is nourishment, physically and spiritually. Finally, their thirst intolerable, one man suggested that they eat the snow, but they were not allowed by the guards to bend over. The person in front of the man agreed to let him eat the snow off his shoulders. Looking around, the people were looking around. That act spread through the entire line in that frozen field. What had been simply one person, one individual struggling, suddenly became a whole community sharing together. Thank you.
As we continue to worship this morning, let's stand together singing Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound.
Thank you.
Father God, thank you for all your many blessings. Thank you for all the things you've done for us. Please be with the sick and those that are needing you, Lord. Also, please be with the tithes and offerings, and thank you for all the many wonderful blessings you've done for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Brothers and sisters, if you have your Bibles, we're going to be in 1 Corinthians chapter 11. 1 Corinthians 11, beginning with verse 23. You know, I had a different introduction for the Lord's Supper today, but it occurred to me while we were singing about God's amazing grace that we have a absolutely perfect picture of what Jesus has done for us and how grateful we should be and how he cares for us and loves us as we celebrate and remember him this morning. I'm going to ask, if you got married at 3 o'clock on December the 30th in Folkestone, Georgia, would you please come up front? Brothers and sisters, we have, number one, a celebration. Can we give a hand to Dylan and Hannah Sloan? Tell them how thrilled we are that God has put you together, that God has brought you both to this church to serve him, and that we are so excited. Okay, Dylan, let me ask you a question now. I asked him this ahead of time just a couple minutes ago to prepare him. How far would you be willing to go to make sure your bride is okay?
As far as it takes.
That's a husband. That is a husband who loves his bride, and we are so proud. By the way, any man that'll stand up in public in front of 400 people and sing, he's got my vote, right? That was awesome. Before we continue with the service, is there anything you guys want to share on your heart? We just want to offer you congratulations and tell you how thrilled we are for both of you that he not only has he brought you together, but he's brought you here.
From the bottom of our hearts, we just want to thank you guys. The amount of love that you guys have poured out on us since last March, but especially in the last few months, just the kindness and well wishes from all of you through just your words, your actions, and your presence has been amazing and uplifting.
Anything?
Ditto.
stay right there for just a second. I'm going to ask him to stay right there for just a second. Everybody, I want you to get a picture of how much this man loves this woman. That is nothing compared to how Jesus loves us. As much as he loves her, he would give his life. Jesus gave it all for us. Thank you guys so much. You can have a seat. Thank you so much. What we're about to do this morning is all about remembering Jesus Christ. That's it, in a nutshell. We are doing this to tell him thank you. Lord, thank you for your grace, your love. He has done so much for us. He gave his blood. He gave his body. He gave everything. He gave his entire life serving us, his bride. Anybody who calls upon the name of Jesus Christ, the Bible says, shall be saved. We are his bride, and we owe him a debt of gratitude. Hey, not only has he taken care of us, gotten us saved, I hope everybody in here is saved. If you're not, you can be saved this morning, be born again today before you leave this church. But he has done that for us, but he also has a future prepared for all of us together with him for eternity in heaven. That's the promise that he's made to us. We're going to celebrate him this morning, and it's all about him, not about any of us, to participate with us. It doesn't matter if you're guests here, we welcome you, but we ask one thing. To participate in the Lord's Supper, we ask that you have made some kind of public decision for Jesus Christ somewhere in your life. You know that you are born again. You know that you've asked Jesus to be your Savior. If you haven't done that yet, if you don't mind, this is not, we're not being ugly or anything, but the Bible commands us, this is for the bride, what we're doing today. If you don't mind, just let it pass by. By the way, if you are saved, if you're not saved, if you choose not to participate today, when it comes to you, just pass it by. Nobody's going to think anything. Nobody's going to say anything. There have been times since I've been born again when I wasn't ready. I needed to do some house cleaning that I let it pass by. So don't anybody feel guilty, okay? We don't want that. Everybody's at home. Relax. We're going to have a great time together. Before we come to the Lord's table this morning, you know, the Bible says to us very explicitly in this passage that Pastor Ryan's going to read a little bit of it. It says, before we come to the table, we must be clean. So before we do anything, we're going to open this altar. I promise you I'll be the first one there. If there's anything that you have in your heart, if there's anything that you, a burden on your heart, it doesn't matter you've sinned because you come up here, but if there's something you want to talk to the Lord about, please come, be clean before we do this. Like I said, if you're afraid of anybody looking at you, they can all look at me because I'll be right there working on my own stuff. Don't neglect this. Don't be shy. The altar's open. You may want to pray in your seat. That's fine too. So I'm going to ask Mary Beth if she'll begin to play, and until everybody's done, we're going to take as long as we need, and we're going to open the altar for time with the Lord. I'd like to ask the deacons to come forward at this time if you're serving this morning. Pastor Ryan is going to read our scripture for us and lead us to the Lord's table.
We'll be in 1 Corinthians chapter 11 this morning, starting in verse 23. It'll be on the screen if you want to follow along. It says, "For I have received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread." Verse 24 says, "And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" Brother Frank Bullard, will you please come and pray over this bread?
Fathers, we come this morning to remember what you told us 2,000 years ago, and we celebrate this time that we can remember, this pause in our lives to remember that you gave the ultimate sacrifice. And as we take this bread and we remember what you did for us and live our lives for you, in Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Deacons are going to serve the congregation first, and then Pastor Ryan and I will serve the deacons, and then we'll all eat the bread together. So everybody, again, if you're going to receive the bread when it comes by, just take a piece and pass it on and hold until everybody's served. Make sure the nursery got served, that they get served. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord, for giving your body for us. Let us eat this bread in his honor. In verse 25, it says, in the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. I'm going to ask Brother Richard Gill to please come pray over the cup.
Our Heavenly Father, God, we thank you, Lord, for the remembrance we're having this morning, Lord, of your body and now your blood, God. We thank you, Lord, for the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary, God, that it covers a multitude of sin, Lord, and that we can have life and life everlasting. Just help us to remember that this morning as we do this in remembrance of you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you, Lord, for shedding your blood for our sins. Let us drink this in his memory. Finally, in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, the final verse 26, it says, "For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes." This morning we've all partaken in the Lord's Supper. And if you don't understand the significance of this bread and the significance of the cup, then I pray that this morning you took that opportunity to fully understand what he did for you on Calvary. At this moment, you're going to have a time to respond. You're going to have a time to reflect and make a decision in your life that is the most important decision that you could ever make. As Mary Beth begins to play, I pray and I hope that you will make that decision. Please come.
Hymn number 470, Without Him. You can stand and sing or respond as you feel led.
Without him, how long? Thank you, everybody. What a wonderful service. That was such a blessing. You know, before I forget, thank you to the deacons always. Thank you, Pastor Ryan, for a great job. I think this was his first Lord's Supper. Also, a big thank you. We often miss her, Miss Barbara Steed, for cooking that wonderful bread every single time. Bless you, Miss Barbara. Thank you so much. Yes, thank you. I got to tell y'all, that's a whole lot better than those square things we used to have. Way back in the day, you remember those? You break your teeth off when you bite down on them. Thank you, Miss Barbara. Bless you for that. Okay, I know y'all are going to be shocked by this, but the pastor messed up last Sunday. Is anybody shocked? No, I've been here long enough. You're not shocked by anything I do anymore. I forgot to ask the church to vote these two young men last Sunday in as deacons. So, Gavin. Okay, Ryan, I'm officially giving it to you now. Somehow you stand up here and your mind just goes blank. I don't know what happens. As a member of this church, this is Gavin Grafford. He came forward and accepted Jesus as his Savior. We baptized him last Sunday. Do I have a motion we make Gavin a member of Southside Baptist Church? So moved. How about a second? All those in favor say amen.
Amen.
Please forgive me for messing up. Hey, buddy, what did I tell you could do now? That's right. I said, you see all those big men right over there? He said, yeah. I said, you're going to be a member of this church. You can vote just like them now. We treat you just like an adult. We're so proud of you. Thank you, buddy, for coming. That last time I apologized for messing up on you. And I got one more to go. When I find Dennis Rollerson, I'm going to get him up here too. So thank you. Let's give him a hand. Thank you so much. We're proud of you. Thank you, buddy. All right. Are there any other announcements before we dismiss?
We have choir practice this Wednesday night at 6:15.
Yes, choir practice at 6:15 Wednesday night. Anything else? We're finishing up tonight at 6 o'clock, our prayer study. Let me tell you, that has been a fantastic prayer study. We prayed specifically Sunday night. I'm going to share this in a sermon in a few weeks, and the Lord's already answered one of our prayers from last Sunday night. Hey, you know what we learned in that study? Go for it. When you pray, go for it. Just ask him. For big stuff, all he can say is no, right? Or wait, or yes. Just go for it. It's going to be a great year in our church. I'm trying to think if there's anything else, any other announcements that we have before we dismiss. Well, you know what? One more time, I'm going to ask the newlyweds to stand at the back door so everybody can just hug you, and then we'll quit. We'll leave you alone after that. But you guys go ahead and go back there. And I'm going to ask Pastor Ryan, he did a great job. Would you pray and dismiss us before I mess something else up?
Let's pray. God, we come together, Lord, humbly, Father, lifting you up, putting you on high, God, where you belong. And we just pray that you are the utmost center of everything that we do. I just pray that this church over the next year continues to grow physically, spiritually, and that we just have this hunger and this thirst for you, God, that cannot be quenched. I just pray, Lord, over each and every single person in here, Lord, I pray that you bless them for coming, bless their families, Lord, and I just pray that you bring us back safely. And I pray all this in your name. Amen.